Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to take a moment to greeting all or greeting you all. Welcome to your first lecture, the first lecture, this course in or at Al Zaytuna University. My name is Shadi Jalud. I'm your instructor for this semester. Okay. In this course, study. Course is the name of the course or the skill. In this course, we will explore the fundamental skills you will need to succeed in your life and in your academic journey. In this course, you will cover the essential study skills, the essential study skills such as the time management and note taking and critical thinking and research tools. We will see the research tools. So the name of the subject, study skills and research. Okay. We will also discuss what we have to we will discuss the in this lecture the essential skills, and we are here to support you and to learn together. We'll study now in the course. The name of the course.
أستاذ بعد إذنك الصوت ضعيف شوي ومو واضح.
Oh. طيب الباقيين صوت واضح عندهم؟ if the problem maybe the problem with the with your device or your connection. The microphone. Yes. The there is a book for this course. Okay, we have a book for this course. The study skills. And we will study now the page 1 and page 2. I will send the book to you after the lecture, inshallah. Okay. We will start with English as your language of instruction. English is your language of instruction. Instruction means learning. Okay. English is now the language of your instruction because it is not your native language. You are now learning the English language. It's not your native language. Okay. Our native language is Arabic. And we are learning English. So study in English may be difficult at the beginning. Your success is your studies will depend upon your ability to understand, ability to speak, ability to read and write English. This textbook or this book is intended to teach you how to use English effectively, okay? In effect way, how to use English in effect way, effectively. As a language of instructions. Now we have three factors that may affect your success. We have three factors, following of factors. Factors, العوامل. There are three factors that may affect your success in your studies. The factors is motivation, concentration, and distraction. Okay, motivation and concentration and distraction. Now, distraction. What we mean by distraction? Okay, motivation is easy, right? Construction is focus or focusing on something. And the third, destruction, the things that prevent you or prevent anyone or someone from giving their full attention. Okay, this is maybe the opposite of concentration. Yeah. It means صرف الانتباه. Destruction صرف الانتباه. Yes, what? Anyone? Yes, the shuttle. Maybe I closed the. If you want to open your mic and see, okay? Because writing, I closing the note here. Okay, I will open it. Yes. Destruction as maybe here Ahmad right, التشتت, yes, المشتتات. Concentration, التركيز, motivation is opening of motivation, التحفيز. Okay. Now we will start with motivation. Motivation refer to the need or desire to achieve a certain goal. Motivation is the need or desire to achieve a certain goal. Maybe you have a goal to achieve it. Okay. If there is no motivation to achieve this goal, maybe you will not succeed. Right? Motivation can make the difference between success and failure. Success and failure. Failure is opposite of that. Motivation can make the difference between success and failure. Now, it is useful to know that good study habits depend upon good motivation. And we have two sources of motivation. We have two sources of motivation. The source maybe come from inside and maybe come from outside. The source of motivation maybe come from inside and maybe from outside. If it comes from inside of you, comes from your hopes and expectations. What do you mean of expectations? Expectations. Yes, where are you? You can participate. You can share your idea. Yes, you want to speak. توقعات. Yeah, very good. Expectation and from your desire to do something or to be something. These inner desires are individual and various. What we mean by individual? Individual, we mean here that maybe my goal is different from your goal. My hope is different from your hope. It's individual. It's special for me. Okay. And various, various is a lot of time maybe. Number two. From outside of you, the source may be from inside and outside. Outside of you, the most common obvious sign of outside motivation is education, or in education is the grade. Can you explain? Anyone can explain this line? How can the grade to be a motivation from outside. Okay. Yes. Explain this idea. Who can explain? I want from you to share your idea here and to try to practice your language, please. No one. Okay. The grade become the here as they said. The common of your kind, the common sign of outside motivation. Why? Because the grade, when you maybe study hard, you will get maybe a high mark. Okay? And this mark will motivate you. This mark, this high mark, will motivate you to study more and more. Okay? Because you will say to your neighbor, your family, and a student that I get a high mark. And this is a big motivation that comes to you from outside. Okay? Understand it? I will try to ask some questions about this page, this motivation. And you have to answer it. Okay. Now, who can answer for the first question? Maybe if I say to you, what does the theorem motivation refer to? What does the theorem motivation refer to? If I write the question at the chat. What does the theorem The question becomes available to everyone. The sound is not clear. Why? Okay, just a minute. I will.
Okay, the question is, what does the theorem motivation refer to? What does the theorem motivation refer to? Okay, who want to answer this question? Yes, you can speak without raise your hand, okay?
Assalamu alaikum.
Ahlan wa sahlan. Okay,
motivation.
Yes.
Motivation refers to the need or desire to achieve certain goal.
Certain goal. Yes, very good. This is the answer for the theorem motivation. The identify or the motivation refer to what? To need and desire. Okay, I want to ask another question. Yes, thank you. So, I don't know who answered. Okay, thank you very much. What is the relation? What is the relation between or the relationship between motivation and study habit? we have a relation between motivation and study habits. What is the relation between them? The study habits and motivation. What is the relation between them? ما هي العلاقة بين study habits عادات أو العادات الدراسية and motivation؟ Okay, what is the answer? The answer is in front of you. The good study habits depend upon good motivation. Okay? The good study habits depend upon good motivation. This is the relation between study habit and motivation. Now, I have another question, which is, what are the two main source of motivation?
From inside of you, from
from
outside of you.
Inside of you, from outside you. Very good. Okay. Is it clear, right? Now, I will make it more difficult. Can you provide me an example of motivation that come from within, that come from inside of you? An example for motivation that come from inside of you. And I need motivation come from outside also.
From inside of you, hobbies and expectations.
Yes, there we have hopes, yes, hopes and expectations and desire. This is where from inside, right? And from outside, what we have? From outside, we have what? We have grades, right? We will go to the second type. Okay, here we have three factors, ثلاث عوامل. Motivation, we finish it. Concentration, okay? Now we will study what? Concentration, okay? Concentration is to concentrate means to focus, okay? The meaning is to focus. To focus what? To focus your attention. Yeah, focus your attention clearly and completely on a purpose. What's the meaning of purpose?
Goal.
Yeah, right. It's your goal. Your purpose is your goal. It is very easy to do this when you are interested in what you are doing. Okay, when you are interested in maybe in the lecture, you will understand it. And if you are not interested in it, okay, you will not understand anything. During your education, there are some subjects that must be... During your education, there are some subjects that must be studied and pass it, even if they don't interest you or don't seem to have any value. I will ask you to explain this.
ممكن بالعربي؟
Okay, no problem. Just once.
أثناء المقصود بهي العبارة إنه أثناء الدراسة ممكن يكون في مواضيع إنه لازم تدرسها أو تنجح فيها، حتى لو ما كنت مستمتع بدراستها أو don't seem إنه ما بيكون فيها قيمة بالنسبة إلك.
Okay, it is not subject here. Maybe it means المواد. Okay, maybe some subjects. You must study it. Okay, like maybe you are now in first year. Okay, what is the subjects that you study it and they are not related in English? Maybe there is Arabic and computers, right?
تمام.
Okay, this is studied, this subject. You have to pass it, you have to study it, right? Even if, حتى لو انه هاي المواد, they don't interest you. Maybe, يعني interviews, ما لك مهتم بالرياضيات, بكمبيوتر او شيء, ولكن يجب ان تدرس هاي المادة. لماذا؟ لانه يعني طبعا الفائده اكبر واعم من انه انت تكون انت فقط مهتم في مجال واحد. don't interest you or you زي ما تهتمالك اهميه فيها, ما انت مهتم فيها مثلا, or don't seem to have any value. بالنسبه لك ما فيها اي value, ما في اي قيمه, ولكن في النهايه اكيد انت يجب ان تكون ملم ب you have some information from all subjects, right? Okay, this is concentration, and here we have how can you develop your interest? The development of the interest. How can you develop your interest? I want to ask someone to read. If you can read this text, who can read? Yes, we have
ممكن
Rama.
أبدأ؟
Okay.
تمام. Think of how and why the subject is important to your general education. For example, physics may not seem interesting to you, but if you want to understand space exploration, a little physics will be helpful.
Yes.
Think of كافي هيك؟
No, just try to explain it. The same idea, maybe, yes.
هلا ممكن مشابه للشيء اللي ذكرته حضرتك سابقا،
نعم,
انه ممكن بعض
very good.
المواد، بعض المواد مثلا مثل الفيزياء، هي ممكن ما تكون مهمة بالنسبة إلي، لكن انا قد احتاج انه هي تكون كمعلومات متوفرة عندي لتوسع افق مثلا.
Yes, very good. Continue, number two. This is the idea, yes.
To think of how the subject is related to other subjects or to other times, places, problems, and purpose. A subject that does not seem interesting in itself may be very interesting in relation to other subjects. For example, ancient history has some relationships to current events.
Yes.
Mathematics is useful in economic.
Okay, very good. Maybe the same idea. يعني المادة ربما ما تجد فيها أنت علاقة مباشرة, ولكن راح تفيدك فيما بعد. Okay. يعني الـ ancient history maybe have a relation to current events, الأحداث الجارية حاليا. Okay, as mathematics also is useful for economy. Right. Okay, maybe we don't have a lot of time to speak a lot of this. Maybe we have only 7 minutes remain. How can you develop your interest? Anyone else? Rama can read. Okay, you do.
Yes.
Else you. Another one, please, Rama. If there is. We have a lot of names. Mustafa, where are you? You can't. We have Ahmad, Osama,
Yes.
Lubna. Yes, don't raise your hand, just say, just speak directly.
أقرأ من الأول.
Who is speaking? أسامة؟
Yes, yes, Matt.
Okay, read please.
Yes. How can you develop your interest? Interest depends upon understanding. For example, if you don't understand the rules of baseball or circuit,
كريكيت كريكيت ربما نعم اللعبة
you cannot have much interest in watching the game
yes
when you game when you begin to study a new subject, try to keep an open mind. Don't start by thinking the subject is boring or difficult. When you fail to learn one point of information, all of the following information depends on it will not be clear to you. Clear you to me to meet to maintain interest and concentration,
concentration.
study, concentration, study regularly, and don't be afraid to ask questions or seek help for anything which you don't know.
Okay, very good, and thank you, Osama, for this reading. Okay, maybe the ideas here clear. If there is anyone can explain briefly, explain in short way what we have read. شرح بسيط من أي شخص. If you can. Not Osama, another one.
كيف يمكن لك تطوير اهتمامك؟ فكر في كيف.
Osama, not you Osama. Another one
Yes.
to explain, yes.
أشرح الأول يعني؟
No, I want someone, not you. Someone else, بدي شخص غيرك يعني. طالب آخر يشرح باختصار اللي قرأناه بشكل سريع. No one. Okay, I will try to explain it. They said here, interest, they speak about interest. And this interest depends on understanding. Okay? If you don't interest in something, that is mean that you don't understand it. Maybe if you watch cricket, كرة المضرب, if you watch it and you don't understand what أو how they are playing. Okay, then you will not be interested in it. Right?
عادي. لا درس هيك عادي صغير.
Okay.
دور عادي. يلا جيت.
Okay, I muted the voice. It mean in Arabic يعني إذا الأمر أنت ما لك مهتم فيه أو أنت ما تفهمه بشكل دقيق فأنت ما راح تكونك مهتم فيه. فهنا حاطين مثال كريكت عن البيسبول. إذا أنت ما لك ما تعرف قواعد هاي اللعبة فأنت لن تكون مهتم بهاي اللعبة. Okay. We go to distractions. Maybe there is no time to, or maybe there is a 1 minute to read it. Distractions هو صرف الانتباه أو تشتت أو مشتتات is something such as sudden noise, the noise that comes from outside. It is distraction, okay? Or someone such as an unexpected visitor that take your attention away from your study, from what you are doing, okay? And can eliminate some distractions. You can eliminate. يمكنك أن تستبعد هذه المشتتات by choosing your place and time. You have to choose the right place and right time to study. You can eliminate other distractions by keeping in good health. Okay. If you aren't in good health, maybe you can't study. There are mainly health problems. We have some health problem that affect a few that make it difficult to concentrate, such as what is this health problem? Poor diet, staying up too late, having headache, or eye problems. Okay, your physical health is important to good study habit. The lecture, we finished the lecture, is the last page here. Maybe you have to read it by yourself under time. There is no time, okay? If you have any question, please ask me at the WhatsApp group. You finished till now, just I want to close. Stop recording. توقف التسجيل. مبين عنكم.